In this video, we're going to take a look at a new app that Apple introduced with iPadOS 26, the phone app. Now we can easily make phone calls directly from our iPad. Let's take a look at this new phone app. Now before we get started, if you like what you see here, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at this new phone app introduced with iPadOS 26 on the iPad. Let's go over to my iPad. So when you look at my iPad here, you're going to see I have this new app, Phone. And basically what this allows me to do is make phone calls directly from the iPad. Let's tap on it to take a look at how this all works. First, we're going to take a look at this interface. Basically, this is divided into different sections. We have our favorites up here. This is where we can favorite different contacts. Below that, we have our recents. So these are all the recent phone calls, incoming and outgoing. In addition to that, if you had any voicemails, you'd be able to see the voicemail there. And then when we go over to the right, we have our details. This is going to be what is selected, the details of whatever is selected from our recents here. And then when we look in the upper right-hand corner, you're going to see edit. This is where I can go and edit a contact. Let's go across the top here. We also have edit up here. What is this? What is different about this edit compared to the one over here on the right? Well, like I said, this one's for editing the current contact. This one actually edits the phone app. Basically, when you tap on this, what I'm able to do is select my name and photo sharing. What am I going to share when I make a phone call? What is the name that is going to show? What is the photo that is going to show? I can edit my favorites, and then I can also select contacts, and then I can remove those contacts as an example. We have filters. This is where I can filter what is shown in my recents here. So when I tap on this, I'm able to select if I want to see my missed calls, my voicemail, my unknown callers, and even manage my filtering. And then we keep going over to the right. We have a number pad. When I tap on this, this is just a number pad, so I can dial a number. This is the phone app, so I can easily dial a number just by tapping on that. And then when we go over to the far right, we have search. So that's the basic layout of the phone app. Now let's take a look at these features individually. We're going to take a closer look at some of these features. Let's first take a look at favorites here. So these are my favorite contacts. So what does that mean? Well, essentially what you can do with any of your contacts is you can favorite how you want to contact them. This could be via messages, it could be via mail, it could be through a phone call. As an example, if we look at my wife here, you're going to see she's in here twice. That's because one of them is for mail and the other one is for phone. So if I wanted to call her right now, I would tap on this and it would start calling her. If I wanted to send her an email, I tap on this. Let's go ahead and do that. And what it's going to do is it's going to open up the mail app and then I can send her a new message. So we can select how we want to contact them. Now, when we're looking at this, you're going to see we have 1, 2, 3. These are the top three. I tap on it and it'll immediately make a phone call or send a message, however I have it set. If we look over to the right, we also have these here. When I tap on this, what it's going to do is it's going to show me a list of all my favorites. So now I tap on it and we have a list of all of my favorites. And again, you're going to see that this one is 1, 2, and 3, and that is why they show right down here, 1, 2, and 3. And then I tap on the other ones to view all the other ones. If I wanted to rearrange these, maybe I don't want to have Abigail as my third one. What I can do is I can edit this, and then I can drag these around. So let's put Johnny up there. Actually, we're going to put Johnny first here, Johnny Appleseed. And now when we look, you're going to see Johnny is 1, Beth is 2, and Beth is 3, email and then phone. So that's how we can rearrange those. If you wanted to remove one, you just swipe over to the left and you can remove it. If you want to view the information, you tap on the little eye here, and then you can view that information. So now that we know how the favorites work, how do we go and add a favorite? Well, to add a favorite, what we need to do is we need to tap on edit. When I tap on edit, you're going to see a little plus here. And from here, what I'm able to do is add a favorite. It's going to look at all of my contacts, and then I can select how I want to add them as a favorite. So let's go with the first one here, Abby. And I can select if I want to message her or mail her. So let's just go with message. So I tap on message. Go to the phone number. And now you're going to see Abby here. And when I tap on her name, what it's going to do is it's going to send a message. So that's how we can easily add them. We can also do this through the Contacts app. If you watch my videos on the Contacts, when I go to my Contacts app here and I look at a specific person, so we'll go with Abby again. I swipe up. You're going to see Add to Favorites. I tap on that. Then I can select how I want to add that person as a favorite. And when I do, what it's going to do is it's going to add them over into this list here. So that's how we work with our favorites. Now let's take a look at recents. So we're going to close this. So these are my recents here, my recent phone calls. And if I had a voicemail from any one of them, what I'd be able to do is view the transcript from that voicemail here. If you want to call them back, you just tap on the little icon here and it'll call them back the same way that they contacted you. So this person here was a FaceTime call. If I tap on that, it'll call via FaceTime. Well, this here was an audio call. I tap on that and it'll call back through an audio call. Now, let's say I wanted to call them back, but I didn't want to use FaceTime. As an example, this call was FaceTime. I don't want to call them back using FaceTime. I'd rather call them back using audio, an audio call. Well, all you need to do is just long press on it, and then you can select how you want to contact them. So you don't necessarily have to use the same way of contacting them as how they contacted you. We can do the same thing with favorites. Let's say I wanted to call Beth back, but I don't want to use audio. I'd like to FaceTime her. I long press on it, and then I can select how I want to call her back. If we want to delete a recent, we just swipe and then we can delete that person from the recent. Let's say I wanted to set a reminder for calling someone back. We can do that as well. All we have to do, let's just go with this one here. All you do is just swipe over to the left and you're going to see this little icon here. When I tap on that, I'm able to set a reminder. So it's going to remind me in an hour tonight, tomorrow, or I can set when I want it to remind me. So if you want to call someone back, but you don't want to do it right now, you can easily set a reminder. Just swipe over to the left. Now let's take a look at our details. So when we tap on a person here, our details show up over here on the right. And then when we swipe up, I can view all the information for that person. If I want to call them or email them or FaceTime, I just tap on the icon here. Pretty simple. If you want to edit a contact, you just tap on edit here. And when I tap on edit, what I need to do is I need to tap on it again, and then a new window opens up and I can edit that contact. So we can also edit contacts directly from the phone app. We'll look at edit in a little bit more detail. I tap on edit. We have a few different options here. What I'm able to do is set name and photo sharing. What is this? Well, when you make a phone call, it's going to share your name and your photo, right? Well, what we're able to do is select what we want to show. So here I can select a new photo. If I wanted to change the photo, I can also set a emoji in there, a monogram, anything like that. And if I want to customize it, I can customize that. If I want to change the poster, this is going to be what shows on the iPhone in the background. We can do that as well. So basically, this is what shows when you make a phone call. Let's go back up to edit. We can also easily edit our favorites. I tap on this, and then I can edit my favorites. I'm going to close this. And then our last option here, when I tap on edit, is select. Basically, when I tap on this, what I'm able to do is select my contacts here. And then if I wanted to mark them as read or delete them, I can do that. Close this. Now let's take a look at filtering. With filtering, what we're able to do is set what we see here. So right now it's showing me my recents. Well, when I go up to filter here, what I'm able to do is have it show all my missed calls as an example. Or what I'd like to do is show all of my voicemails. So you want to see only your voicemails. This is how you can filter that out. And you can also set it to show just your unknown callers. Now, if you don't see that, what you need to do is you need to tap on Manage Filtering. First time you open it up and you go to Manage Filtering, what it does is it opens up the phone settings, and then what you want to do is you want to turn that on. And once you turn that on, you're going to see the option to filter your unknown callers. So that's how we can easily filter our calls. And then when we go over to the right, this is pretty self-explanatory. We tap on the number pad to dial a number. And then we also tap on search to search our contacts. Now, we do have a few options with the phone app. We can respond with a text. We can record phone calls. We can use hold assist detection. We can even screen unknown callers. How do we set all this up? Well, what we need to do is we need to go to the settings app. We need to go to the phone app settings. So I'm going to swipe up here, and then we're going to go over here to settings. From here, what we need to do is we need to swipe up and go over here to apps. I tap on apps. And then we swipe up until we find phone. I tap on phone, and then we have all of our different phone settings. So let's take a look at a few of these settings. The first thing is we can set who we want to share our name and photo with. Remember how we can set what we share, what our name is, what our photo is? Well, who do we want to share it with? I have mine set to contacts only. So only people in my contacts are going to be able to view this information. It's only going to share that information with people in my contacts. All right, let's take a look at calls here. What is this? Well, basically what we're able to do is we're able to respond with text on a call. So if a phone call comes in, what you're able to do is set different responses. I tap on this, and then I can set, sorry, I can't talk right now. I'm on my way, or can I call you later? And then what it'll do is it'll text them. So if you can't catch that call right now, what you're able to do is at least send a message if you wanted to. We can also record phone calls now. You tap on this to turn it on. And then when you're on a phone call, you're going to have an option to record that call. When you record that call, the other person is going to get an alert saying that this phone call is going to be recorded. So the other person will know that you are recording them. Let's keep going up here. We also have hold assist detection. This was introduced with iOS 26 on the phone. Basically, what you're able to do is you're able to automatically detect when you are placed on hold. So you're going to hear that background music. Well, basically, what you're able to do at that point is you're able to step away. You don't have to listen to that anymore. The iPad will listen to that music, and when that music stops, it's going to alert you and say you're no longer on hold. So basically, when you're put on hold, when this is turned on, the iPhone or the iPad will detect this, and then it'll just listen to it for you, so you don't have to listen to that background music anymore. So I recommend leaving this on or turning this on. And then we have live voicemail. So when someone is leaving a voicemail, you're actually going to be able to see what that voicemail is in text. Keep swiping up. And then we can also screen unknown callers. We have a few different options here. Our first option, never. What this will do is calls from unsaved numbers, so they're not in your contacts, what it'll do is it'll ring, and then missed calls will be displayed on the recents list. So basically, this is not going to screen any unknown callers. It's going to show just like someone in your contacts. Well, if you don't like that, if you get a lot of calls, I get a lot of calls, unknown callers, what you can do is you can tell it the iPhone to ask for a reason. So basically, the iPhone will answer, or the iPad, sorry, your iPad will answer the phone call, and then it's going to ask for a reason. Why are you calling? The person has to respond, and then it'll tell you why they're calling. So it's kind of like a little bit of a screening. Why are you calling? And then from there, you're going to be able to answer it. And then we can also silence. This is more of the extreme. Calls from unsaved numbers will be silenced. So basically, you're not going to hear it ring. It's going to be sent directly to voicemail, and it's going to be displayed in your recents. So when you go to the phone app, you're going to see it in the recents, but it's not going to ring. So you can choose from one of those three options for unknown callers, people that are not in your contacts. And then our last one here is call filtering. We kind of touched on this. What this is going to do is this is going to separate people that are unknown callers. So that's the new phone app that was introduced with iPadOS 26. Not only can we make calls, but we can also favorite contacts. We can filter our contacts. We can even screen unknown callers or use hold assist detection, just like we can with the iPhone. And just so you know, this is also available on the Mac with macOS 26. So that's the new phone app that was introduced with iPadOS 26. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video. You can subscribe to my channel. You can share it with your friends and family. In addition to that, if you want to help support my efforts in making these videos, you may want to check out danstutorials.com or dansonlinecourses.com. Danstutorials.com is a membership-based site, and when you become a member, not only do you get more videos, but you also get an AI assistant modeled after an Apple Genius, and you can attend classes and webinars that I hold on a regular basis. This is a subscription-based website, and if you don't like subscriptions, I also have another option, dansonlinecourses.com. This is where I have my courses. As of this recording, I only have one course on there for the iPhone, which includes lessons for iOS 18 and iOS 26. But I plan on including a course on the iPad, which will include this video as well as several others. These are one-time purchases. They're not a subscription. So if you don't like subscriptions, check out dansonlinecourses.com. With either one of these, just know that you are helping support a small business. It is just me in a corner office of my house. I'm not part of some large organization. So when you become a member or you buy a course or do both, I do have people that do both, you are helping support a small business. Check out danstutorials.com or dansonlinecourses.com for more information. And thanks for watching.